Welcome to 2 plus 0 dash cooking, and we are making sweet daikon carrots today. If you've never made Vietnamese sweet daikon carrots before, then stick around. Hello, my name is Beef, and if this is your first time here, thank you for stopping by. I make small tasty recipes for me and my plus one out of our tiny apartment kitchen. Our recipes are small, easy on the budget, and easily scalable for more servings. So let's get cooking on these sweet daikon carrots. Hello everybody. If you've ever had a Vietnamese sandwich, this is the condiment that makes it taste the way it tastes. This daikon is probably about 5 to 6 inches. Normally, this root vegetable, when I buy it at Food Max, it's usually about twice as big. But they all came out small, which is good for me because they sell this by the pound and it's not cheap. It has a nice radish flavor to it. If you can't get daikon at your market, buy radishes. It tastes exactly the same. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and peel this off. Same thing with the carrots. I just use a potato peeler. And then what we're going to do is cut this down into strips. I'm not a chef. I mean, I'm a home cook. Just like 95 to 98% of everybody out there. You're a home chef and you're trying to make the best meals for you and your family. So I'm not going to blow hot air up your ass and try to tell you that I'm a Bobby Flay or whatever. But the one thing that I do have going for me is that I know what I like to eat. I know what makes my plus one happy, and the people that I've served this to, I know that it makes them happy because they always ask me, where did you buy that? when people ask you, where did you buy something that you're serving to them, that's when you know you are hitting that high note. So based on this, I was originally putting it in here. It could still work. This is a classico jar for, you know, like a spaghetti sauce and stuff. You know, I know how to make spaghetti sauce, but it's hard to find canning jars that fit in our fridge. And I always keep all my pickled stuff at the bottom of the fridge in a plastic tub. And it's so shallow that I find it very hard to get jars that will actually fit in the tub. And if you have a lot of glass jars with pickles, I suggest you put them in tubs. And one day, one of these suckers are going to crack. And this is the one that really throws me for the loop every time I make this. It just seems like a lot. We are going to go ahead and sweat these bad boys. And you would be surprised. I'm just using regular iodine salt. I'm salting it up really well. I'm probably using a tablespoon, maybe two. Okay, so we're back. It's been like about an hour. And yeah, these carrots and daikon have gotten really macerated. So what we're going to do is I need to squeeze all this moisture that was pulled out of these veggies out of here. And even after I did that, I really need to get in there and squeeze even more moisture out. So this is where we're at. We've got about a little over 1.5 cups of veggies here, and we have 2 cups of water, and this 2 cups of water is based on this jar. So we're dealing with 1/2 cup of fluid. 1-2 tablespoons of sugar. I'm just gonna put a little bit more. We're just gonna go 3 tablespoons. But we're gonna go ahead and add the vinegar and add that 2 parts in. That brings it up to about 1/3. We're going to put a little water in it to bring it up to 1/2. I'm going to go ahead and put this in the microwave for about 2 minutes. Yeah, this vinegar, water, and sugar It all like melded together. Let's go ahead and get these veggies into the jar. Oh no, we're not short. It's just that it's not compressed. Let's push it down. I'm not sure. It's probably going to last this maybe 2 weeks or something. And you guys out there that pickle, keep doing what you do. Please let me know what I'm doing wrong, because I just want to get better at pickling, because pickling is just awesome. Thank you so much for watching this video on making Vietnamese sweet daikon carrots. If you like this video, then please like us below. There are also links on this screen for other 2+0 dash cooking recipes. Remember to subscribe and you'll be notified of new videos every week. As always, I have a summary of this recipe below in the description, and also please visit our website, 2+0-cooking.com. If you have any comments or ideas, then please post them below. We love hearing from our viewers and answering their questions. We also invite our viewers to share their ideas or recipes with each other in the comment section. Thank you for watching, looking forward to hearing from you, and see you soon. Beef out. As always, the following are dishes that are taken to another level by using the pickles we made today. Enjoy. Thank you.